The years no doubt have changed me.
It's a truly amazing cast. Helena Bonham Carter, Sacha Baron Cohen, and Alan Rickman. I'd watch this movie just to watch these guys.
This is definitely one of my favorite characters. Seeing Johnny play the monster in a way is fantastic.
Tim and I did our first movie together like 17 years ago. He knows me pretty much better than anyone.
All right! You, sir, how about a shave? Come and visit your good friend, Sweeney.
You just look at Johnny's body of work and you realize that this is a man who holds himself to the highest possible standards.
His choices are always really clever, and he's always great fun to watch, and he's always having fun.
Seems like the fates are favoring you at last, Mr. T.
Now that I see Helena Bonham Carter playing Mrs. Lovett, I can't imagine anybody else playing it.
Wait, where's your rush? Where's your hurry?
I saw Mrs. Lovett as totally amoral and somebody who was as zestful and vital as Sweeney was depressive and introverted.
I think she'd rather he didn't think about killing so much.
The main thing that defines Mrs. Lovett is that she's tragically in love with somebody who doesn't love her back.
Helena came in and whipped it beyond recognition. She's just beautifully made it her own.
She's a real lady.
That she is.
Mr. Todd?
At your service.
Alan Rickman has always been one of my favorite actors. He's able to be bad, but he had a strange vulnerability about him as well. I look at him and you kind of don't really want to know what he's thinking.
He doesn't know that he's got an appalling set of morals. He's a very successful judge, dishing out sentences to poor, presumably innocent young people.
May the Lord have mercy on your soul.
My character, Beadle Bamford, is a real nefarious, nasty piece of work, really.
Oh, thank you, sir. You are a paragon of integrity.
Well, I try to do my best for my friends and neighbours. He always likes to feel he is a pillar of the community, but in fact he's completely venal, totally untrustworthy, and very, very violent.
Next time, it'll be your pretty little brains all over the pavement.
Mr. Todd.
Signor Pirelli.
Pirelli's the competing barber in town. He is a big comic character.
And it's just hysterical, his Pirelli.
Toby starts off being Signor Pirelli's servant, in a way. And he's not treated very well at all until he's sort of adopted by Miss Lovett.
Ed Saunders started off about this tall, and now we're finishing the film and he's about that tall.
You all right there?
Leave the bottle.
I'm playing Joanna, which is actually Sweeney Todd's daughter, but he hasn't seen her since she was one.
Joanna.
He has her locked in a madhouse.
Anthony's character is very young. Although he's been to all these different places in the world, he's still very naive. And I think he's just overwhelmed by Joanna's beauty.
So we run away and then all our dreams come true.
They had just a certain freshness to them that we felt was important to those characters. You know, all the other characters are screwed up and nuts. And it just felt like to balance against that, you just wanted a certain purity.
These are desperate times, Mrs. Lovett. The desperate measures are called for.
Every character has a sort of different agenda and a different passion, and there's something that's very funny and dark about all of that together.
It's truly impressive. It's astonishing.
Now, Mr. T, surely one's enough for today.
How about a shave?